Well, I never thought I'd say this, but I found, once I'd been in the work for a while and had met some other parents and got my feet on the ground, that research honestly gave me hope. And the connection for me, and I it's not original, some mother said this to me at a conference, is that research helps us to establish need, and it validates need. And most of the time, I think, as parents, we deep down know the need, but I'll speak for me. I didn't always have the scientific knowledge or the credibility to move forward with it. And so in hearing about the research often validated what I was experiencing. And I learned that with research, that policy can be created. And with policy, there can be change. And so it might not even be change for my son. So sometimes in my endeavors with research or listening to research or thinking about participating as a parent with a job, I had to think, it's about me to a certain degree, but it's also for the kids and the families to come.
You know or intuitively get with what you're experiencing with your child, and you know, to have that validation come through with research is like, wow, okay, I'm not nuts when everybody else seems to be saying that.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
And you're just the caregiver. How could you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that I think is so important to have that validation through the research results.
I am so grateful for research, and especially the newer emerging research that is a slight bit more hopeful. And also, I feel like a bit more, well, responsive to what caregivers are saying that we're seeing. And for me, having research and evidence has helped me to guide systems that are not FASD informed.
Because with the kids that I've got all these medical issues, and I don't talk to many people that help kids with medical issues, and the research alone on all the medical background and everything that was going on, it made a world of difference. Just opened my eyes. You know, it's not just me. There are actually more out there. And with research, it gets out there that people aren't just looking. And like I said, with the autism, that's something I've been saying all along, is they've got to be connected. And just with the research, I think that could go further. Mm-hmm. I know exactly where that connection is.
The reason I wanted to make sure my children were part of the studies is because I wanted to prove the possibilities. I wanted to prove that they could do certain things. And this is a time when it was all negative. Mm-hmm. You heard about all the things they couldn't do, and it was really hard to sort of navigate the FASD world at that time and feel hopeful.
With their attitude of researchers, especially connected with CAN-FASD, they're open-minded. And they're willing to hear from the lived experience. And what we're doing is validating their research, and they're validating our lived experience. So mm-hmm. we have these two eyes seeing, this concept of two eyes seeing. So you have the lived experience, and you have the research evidence, and they inform each other. So that we're validated in both ways, and we have more power. We can use that to advocate for services to improve the lives of our children.
CAN-FASD, with all the researchers that we've had the opportunity to interact with, it was brought up as is that they're people and they listen and they're compassionate. And, you know, they take, like I said, the time to listen, and then they move forward on that research. And like everyone keeps saying, it just validates everything that we're doing, whether we're navigating the medical field and we're struggling with all these physical pieces, and we're struggling for people to believe us. If we can take the research and the evidence in there, that piece isn't going to be so hard. And even as raising a younger child who's has FASD, like Marcia said, it's not going to change overnight. But always when I'm in there and I'm in those appointments, I just keep thinking, okay, like you said, it's not going to change, but maybe the kids that are coming up behind us is going to make a difference for them.
Mm-hmm. You're saying, I think the research also allows us to enter into conversations with the professionals.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So that it's not, oh, you're a parent, and you know, you're reacting as a parent, you're blah, blah, blah. No, here's some evidence.
Mm-hmm.
You know, why don't you read this article? Why don't you read, like, you know, this whole FASD as a whole body disorder? Like, this article is going straight to my daughter's physician. Mm-hmm. That's for sure when I come back.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully with the research, we can get rid of the stigma.
Yes, mm-hmm. Exactly.
You know, and yes. I think that would make things a lot easier.
Yes.
We can get rid of that stigma that it's not his fault.
Right.
And as we know, it's true. So I think we need to...
Yes.
You know, we need that backup. Not just, it's fine.
And have a message in that.
Right.
Yeah.
And the stigma for individuals as well, right?
Exactly.
So, as you guys, right, on the BSD is such a negative world, and
yeah.
The stories out there are negative, and you
yeah.
read those stories. So, you know, when you're raising
yes.
kids that are younger, and you're reading that, that's the world that we're up against, and like, holy man, it's a scary place.
Mm-hmm.
And with research will come the right education, and kind of this. Simone was talking about having, like, validating caregivers and what they're doing is correct, but also if that research is out there and we're validating caregivers, we're going to have more caregivers coming on board.
Yes.
They're not going to be scared of the word FASD.